These walls of stone are silent observers.
History runs deep.
Embracing a home filled with generations of stories.
This place matters.
But neighbors of the quirky cottage along West Seattle's Harbor Avenue are fighting to preserve those stories for the generations to come.
The reality is we have to act soon. Time and gravity are not on the side of this building.
A woman named Eva Falk lived in the house for most of the last century. She and her mother built the structure during the Great Depression with some help from jobless men.
She would, you know, house them and feed them, and they would help her put the rocks on the building.
From all accounts, Eva was a remarkable woman.
She was in a religious cult in Ballard for a while. She married the strong man in the circus who reportedly was able to bend horseshoes with his teeth.
Yes, my father.
Carmesita Munoz is Eva's daughter. As a little girl, she helped fetch the beach stones that line the building's walls.
We walked around Alki, the 2 miles, past the lighthouse, to pick up the stones. I was told to either pick up black rocks only or white for the trim.
Little stone house.
Neighbor Ken Workman, a descendant of Chief Seattle, says the home's wood and stone forever hold the spirit of the Duwamish.
These rocks right here were gathered from the beach. Inside the house, one of the supporting walls are massive cedar timbers that were hand split and hand hewn. So from a native perspective, this is home.
But the property is slated for condo development, so the building has to move.
This little stone cottage is going to be lifted onto a truck.
I think we're going to eventually shrink wrap it to try and hold it together. And I'm real confident we're going to be able to move it without breaking it.
This little stone cottage will be parked nearby until it can find a permanent home, a place where it can tell its stories for centuries to come.
This needs to be saved.